Tonight, some new details are emerging as authorities raid an underground bunker in Alabama and rescue a 5-year-old boy. Now, we have learned the FBI spent 7 days planning the rescue while hostage negotiators kept James Lee Dykes talking right across the street. They practiced in a makeshift bunker. When their hidden camera showed an agitated Dykes holding a gun, they swooped in and started shooting. And tonight, little Ethan is safe and Dykes is dead. The governor of Alabama thanked all of those who prayed for Ethan and thanked the authorities who didn't give up.
Like our law enforcement men and women who were patient and persistent with their planning for the right outcome. Please join me tonight in thanking them for a job well done.
And we do have some remarkable insight tonight on just how much danger the little boy in Alabama was in.
KMBC 9's Martin Augustine is in our newsroom with the details. Martin?
Well, in that sense of danger is the critical key toward launching a rescue. This from a former FBI agent living here in Kansas City.
It's a very tough situation.
Retired FBI agent Jeff Lanza says this scenario with James Lee Dykes in an underground bunker with his hostage, 5-year-old Ethan, would have been dangerously precarious for negotiators, who must be patient, but not too patient. Reports are James Lee Dykes had a gun and was agitated. Lanza says negotiators also likely spotted behavior in Dykes that was demeaning and dehumanizing toward Ethan, even beyond the kidnapping itself.
Usually, normal people, they have to objectify somebody, dehumanize them before they put their hands on them. When you see that kind of behavior in words, verbally and non-verbally, usually the next step is violence.
Lanza says the rescue team was likely there in Alabama within hours of the standoff beginning, practicing for days. We now know negotiators convinced Dykes to approach the bunker door to accept the delivery of an item. Their FBI agents set off an explosive device. Dykes started shooting. They fired back, killing Dykes and rescuing Ethan. I asked Lanza, did Ethan's age influence the decision to launch the dangerous rescue?
I don't think so. Once you sense that that hostage is in danger, you go in. Doesn't matter whether they're 90 or 9 or 5 going on 6. You just go in.
Now, such a rescue is, of course, a calculated risk. Lanza says that 3/4 of hostage situations end without anybody being injured, but that means there are 25% of these situations that end where somebody is hurt, if not worse. Len.
All right. Thank you, Martin. Authorities say Ethan seems to be bouncing back from his awful ordeal. He will turn 6 years old tomorrow.